Hello everyone, this is Funny. You are watching Funny HS Info YouTube channel. Today I am going to talk about crane safety. Cranes are one of the most versatile, powerful and important pieces of equipment commonly found on construction sites. They can be used to accomplish a lot of heavy lifting tasks, saving the amount of time and energy spent on a project. Workers whose job involves working with and around cranes need to understand the hazards of moving parts and rigging of loads. Hazards relating to this type of equipment can include striking injuries from moving equipment, rising or dropped loads, crushing injuries from equipment overturnings, breaking or rigging failures, falls from performing work at heights, electrocution from contact with overhead power lines, overloading a crane can cause it to tip over or to drop the load, which can have devastating consequences. Next one, crane inspection. First one, hook. This category will check things like the openings of the hook, checking for cracks or corrosion, how much wear is on throat, and other details. Wedge sockets. Looking at the wire rope size, the dead end of the wire rope, and ensuring the wire rope is properly secured. Sheaves. Check to ensure the wire rope is seated into the sheaves, that the keepers are in good working order, the bolts are tightened correctly, and for any signs of damage or wear. Boom. Look for the hydraulic leaks, watch for the lattice extension issues, and check all around the boom for bent, buckled or cracked panels. Fluids. Checking all the fluids in the crane to ensure they are at the necessary levels. Tires. Tires must be inflated to the required levels and should not have any cuts, bulges and signs of wear. And any other things that need to be checked on a given crane before it is operated. Next we will discuss about the safety instructions to be followed by the crane operators, riggers, supervisors. First one, rigger. A qualified rigger as one who has the training and experience or certification to perform rigging operations and solve problems related to rigging, such as assembling, disassembling, initial connections of the loads to the components or structures, unhooking, unhooking, are guiding loads if the workers are in the loads area. safety instructions for rigger. Check the slings and ensure the rigging angle is correct. Make sure the load is properly secured and inform the crane operator of the weight of the load. Make sure the lifting gears such as hooks, slings and shackles are in good working condition. Make sure the load is stable, balanced and secured before any lifting operation. Make sure any loose items are placed in a proper receptacle or container to prevent any items from falling during the lifting operation. Immediately report any defective or faulty lifting gear to the lifting supervisor. Place adequate padding on the edges of the load to prevent the sling from damage. Use tag line with sufficient length and diameter so that the tag line can easily gripped and the load stabilized. Signalman. Signal person is required for any rigging or lifting operations where the operator cannot see where the load is to be placed. Signalers must know and understand the hand signals and other communication methods used on their work site. The signal person must stay in the constant contact with the operator while the load is being moved. Safety instructions for signalman. Check with the rigger that the load is ready to be lifted before giving the signal to lift. Give the correct crane hand signals clearly to the crane operator to lift the load. Ensure the load is correctly rigged up prior to the giving signals to commence the lift. Ensure the lift is controlled throughout the duration of the operation. Ensure that the immediate areas within the lift are clear on any hazards during the lifting. Maintain his position so as to ensure line of sight during the control phase of the lift and to ensure this position is free of danger. Crane operator. Operators are responsible for directly operating the crane, derrick or other lifting equipment. Operators must be aware of their crane's operating characteristics and must know how to maintain their equipment. Safety instructions to the crane operator. Refer to the load chart and identify the working load of the crane. Be familiar with the crane operations and its controls. Conduct operational tests on all limiting and indicating devices under no load condition at the start of every shift. Record the test results in a logbook or sheet. Ensure the permit to work has been issued before the start of any lifting operation. Ensure that the ground condition has been assessed safe for crane travel and lifting before starting any operation. Ensure that outriggers are set up on a FEM and leveled down. Fully extended all outriggers and secure the jacks on the base plates. Hoist a load after clear signal is given from the signalman. Do not use the crane to pull or drag any load. Conduct all lifting operations within the designated area or cordon of road. Identify the weight of the load and ensure it is within the safe working load of the crane before hoisting. Perform all lifting operations at least 3 meters away from the overhead power lines. Do not leave the crane unattended while a load is suspended in a mid-air. Do not operate cranes in severe weather conditions such as rain, strong winds, and under poor lighting conditions. Keep a regulatory update, maintenance, and operation logbook or sheet. Next one, lifting supervisor. The person who is in charge with actively supervising the lifting operations on site. The person could be foreman, shift supervisor, or other similar capacity. Safety instructions for lifting supervisor. Ensure that a valid crane operator license available with the operator. Ensure that crane has a valid certificate of test and examination issued by authorized examiner. Ensure that a lifting plan has been established for the load and the entire lifting team has been briefed on the plan. Coordinate all lifting activities in accordance with the lifting plan. Brief all lifting team members on the lifting plan, safe lifting procedures, and risk assessment. Take suitable measures to rectify unsafe conditions so that the lifting operations can be conducted safely. And finally, the safe lifting rules. Prepare lifting plan with a safe work procedure. Ensure lifting equipments are in good working condition. Ensure that qualified lifting team is appointed. Apply and seek approval for permit to work. And monitor lifting operations at all times. Thanks for watching Funny EHS Info. For any questions, please text me in comments. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a safe day. Thanks for watching Funny AHS Info. For any questions, please text me in comments. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a safe day.